I'm just very grateful, Stacy, for this evening, because there are times in my life, many, many, many times, when I think I've gone mad, you know, because I keep reading a characterization of the women's movement and of feminism, which is not what I experienced in real life, you know. Whether it was, you know, being in the famous Martin Luther King March. I mean, you know, I was nothing. I was just another marcher, you know. But the woman next to me, African-American woman and her daughter, Mrs. Green, with the, I mean, she pointed out to me that there were no women on the podium who were speaking. I did not notice that. You know, she pointed it out to me. And when I interviewed Fannie Lou Hamer for sterilization for the ACLU, which I have to say Ruth Ginsburg was pursuing for the ACLU. And it was, and she was very, very clear that she had been sterilized without her knowledge or permission in a Mississippi hospital at the very same time when white women had to have 3 or 4 children and their husbands written permission in order to have a tubal ligation. I mean, she, to me, was the source of the first understanding of reproductive freedom and reproductive justice as a fundamental part of the women's movement. I mean, and not only that, but from a national point of view, in the first issue, or one of the first issues of Ms. Magazine, we did a Lewis Harris, very respectable national poll of women's opinions on women's issues in this country, on specific issues and on the women's movement in general. And more than 60% of black women supported the women's movement and feminist issues, and only 30-some percent of white women. Now, cut to the last election. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. 51% of white married women voted for Trump, and 95% of black women voted for Hillary Clinton. And yet people think that the women's movement is, you know, a white middle class. I'm gonna just kill myself. So, so I'm so grateful for this. For this evening, because it confirms my life experience, it confirms objective reality in every possible way, and I so hope that it will just not, I mean, I've had 4 speaking partners in my life, black women who, Flo Kennedy, you know, who made me what I am today, I hope she's satisfied. Every joke I tell is actually stolen from Flo. And Margaret Sloan, but anyway. I just hope that tonight is a turning point. I just don't think I can bear it anymore, you know. And people say to me online, white feminism, and I say, are you kidding me? If it's white, it's not feminism. Yeah. Hello? No.